The ruling All Progressive Congress, APC, has displayed certificates of all the six governorship aspirants seeking the party's ticket ahead of the September 19 Edo State governorship election. The credentials of Governor Godwin Obaseki and five other aspirants who have but completed and submitted the party's expression of interest and nomination forms on display include Pastor Osagie Eze Iyamu, Dr. Pius Odubu, Engineer Chris Ogia Wumi, Honorable Osaro Obaze, and Honorable Matthew Aigbu Jose. These credentials were on display at both the National Secretariat of the party in Abuja and the Edo State Chapter Office in Benin City. Joining us now is legal practitioner Odiana Ariata. Thank you very much for joining us.
Thank you. Good morning.
Good morning. What could be responsible for this process of screening where they would have to display credentials opening? Can't the screening committee investigate and come out with their findings and clear these people?
Yes, I think the displaying of the credentials of the aspirants in Edo State of that of APC came out of the experience they have from Bayelsa State. In the case of David Leon, Bayo Barokuma, Remi Eyo, who won a fair and credible election, but were sacked because of the credentials provided by the deputy governor, which was doubted and affirmed not credible by the Supreme Court. Borrowing from that experience, the National Working Committee of APC see that as a very good excuse to publish the credentials of the six aspirants on their platform in Edo State and at the National Working Committee Board to enable the public have opportunity to scrutinize the credentials and credibility of all the documents provided by those aspirants, which is the sitting governor, His Excellency Godwin Obaseki, Pastor Osagie Eze Iyamu, Honorable Gewoyi, Chief of Gewoyi, Dr. Pius, you know, Dubu, Osaro Obaze, and Iduo Ikeme. I think they are is well-funded, because if you also look at the Electoral Act, by virtue of Section 31(5), the INEC is also going to display the credentials of the candidates after the primaries for the public scrutiny as well. So it's not out of place if documents submitted by aspirants are displayed for the purpose of scrutiny by the public.
Now, considering the power play and the intrigues that has been ongoing before now, and is still on, do you expect to see post-primary that these aspirants will accept whoever comes out from that primary as the sole candidate of the party, or do you expect some sort of litigation?
Yes, it's not totally unexpected. Litigations are already ongoing even before the primary elections. As we speak, there is a case going on at the State High Court in Edo State, you know, interrogating the membership of the party by one of the aspirants. There's also another litigation at the Federal High Court in Edo State, in Isipi, also questioning the powers of the National Working Committee of APC to conduct direct primaries in place of indirect primaries, which is favored by the sitting governor. So all that we see now is not a big deal. It's already known as part of the contestation process or the electoral process in any of the governorship or presidential or National Assembly elections. It's not totally out of place. I see a situation that after the primaries on the 22nd of June, there's likely going to be some form of rancor, but whether we like it or not, there's going to be a return by the National Working Committee to INEC, because so many of these processes are time bound. If you are dissatisfied with the process, you can still go to court. You know, you are at liberty to challenge the process. But definitely, I know majority of the contestants or aspirants are going to agree with the party, whatever the result is at the end of the 22nd day of June.
Okay, let me just chip this one in before we're out of time. The security situation, I'm sure there are concerns about, you know, safety of persons who will be going to take part in that primary. What efforts do you think are being put in place to forestall any breakdown of law and order, considering the height of tension that we have when it comes to the primaries?
Well, I think the issue of security is also very paramount and important in the circumstance. I will employ the state security agents, the federal security agents, to be on ground to oversee the process. Because on one part, the National Working Committee that is legally empowered to direct the mode of primary, the date, the time, and the venue had said we are going to do the direct primary, which will take place in all the 192 wards. On the other hand, the governor, His Excellency Gordon Obaseki, and his group are saying we are going to do indirect primaries that will ensure converging over 4,000 delegates at the stadium, Samuel Gbemudia Stadium. For me, I think the security issue must be looked into by both parties and by the federal government.
All right, Barrister Odiaria, thank you very much for joining us.
Thank you. I appreciate you.